Hello everyone, I'm Ritika Jain, presently working as a dietitian and fitness coach. Today, being a part of Adore India, I'm here to share with you all something about immunity. The time which is going on in the entire world, it's a very tough time for the whole world. But our own country is completely locked down. It's the time when we should stay home and build our immunity. Before knowing how to build our immunity, we should know what is immunity. Let's understand what is immunity. In our body, we have immune system. It consists of vast number of cells, tissues, proteins and organs. When all of them coordinate together, they help us to protect against pathogens or the foreign particles. Our body consists of WBCs, which stands for white blood cells. These white blood cells act as a security guard or the scanner. They continuously screen for any of the foreign particles or the pathogens present in our cells, blood or organs. In case they detect these pathogens in our body, they immediately send a signal to the brain. Brain kicks in the immune response and prevent us falling prey to these pathogens. Now, before knowing how to build immunity, let's know what lowers down our immunity. In today's world, where we live with mobile phones, gadgets, laptops, all this leads to irregular sleep cycle which disturbs our biological clock. A disturbed biological clock causes a hormonal imbalance in our body, leading our immune system to go for a complete toss. In the urban world which we live, we have easy access to processed food and white sugar. The processed food and white sugar provides the food for the bad bacteria in our gut, and they prevent the growth of good bacteria, thus hampers the release of antibodies in the gut. These antibodies only help us or they prevent the pathogens to grow in our body. The third point is stress. Stress is one of the very common term nowadays. Even if you go and talk to a 10-year-old kid, he has different degree of stress at his own levels, and I don't know why. Might be stress is unavoidable for every individual, but if we find out ways, we can easily manage stress. One of the effective way to manage stress is meditate. Meditate at least 5 to 10 minutes every day. When our immune system sets in and if we detect the presence of pathogens, they need to divide very rapidly. For the rapid division, they need good amount of vitamins and proteins in our body. If our body is low in vitamins or proteins, the immune cells won't be able to divide. Especially vitamin D levels. If we have low levels of vitamin D in our body, it has the tendency to lower down our immunity. So it is important for us to note these points and improve here. Now let's know what are the foods which help us to boost immunity. Coconut oil. Coconut oil has two main ingredients, lauric acid and the caprylic acid. Both of these act as an immunoregulator. They help us to boost the immunity. 1 teaspoon of coconut oil, if added to a day's meal, it helps us to boost the immunity. Star anise. Star anise is a flower-shaped spice. Star anise contains acid called shikimic acid. The easiest way to extract the shikimic acid out of the star anise is to boil it in water and then drink that water. This shikimic acid is the main ingredient which is being used in the preparation of anti-flu drug like Tamiflu. Other spices like turmeric, dry ginger powder, black pepper, oregano, thyme, tulsi, all these spices or the herbs are very helpful in boosting immunity. We can add them in our various meals or soups or any of the tea which we drink. This will help us to boost the immunity. Various fruits like citrus fruits, papaya, amla, lemon, oranges, lime. All these fruits have good amount of vitamin C. Vitamin C is a very good source of ascorbic acid. They help us to fight any of the pathogens or the bacteria present in our body or they indirectly boost the immunity. While we are at home, it's not a right option for us to munch on easily available packaged foods. It's better if we take out time and refills our dabbas, which we keep in our home, with almonds, cashew nuts, walnuts. So in case if we are hungry, we munch on them, but in right proportion. Probiotics. Probiotics provides the food for the good bacteria in your gut. There are various sources of probiotics which you can include in your diet. The one easy and the easily available at every Indian home is curd. If you include a cutori of curd in our diet, it provides a good source of probiotics to your gut bacteria. A cup of green tea. Green tea has flavonoids which act as antioxidants. These antioxidants fight against any of the toxic substances present in your body. And yes, not to forget garlic and ginger. This both helps to reduce inflammation. One clove of garlic have enough sulfur compounds and a compound called allicin, which helps to fight against the pathogens. So please consume the above mentioned food in your diet as and when possible. And most importantly, not to forget, while at home, it's not an excuse to be more sedentary or lethargic. Move more, be active, exercise at least 15 minutes a day, go on your terrace or any of the room available, at least work out for 10 to 15 minutes. The more we move, our lymphatic system, our lymphatic fluid flows better in our body and thus helps the WBCs to find and screen the pathogens better. Stay home, stay safe, boost your immunity. Thank you.